consultations with her husband, Okezie Ikpeazu, who had just been sworn in as governor in May 2015. Mrs. Nkechi Ikpeazu, as is typical with most first ladies on assumption of public office by their husbands, created the Vika Hope Foundation, a platform through which she envisioned to realize the role thrust on her as the bastion of the underprivileged, the vulnerable, and the sick. From its earliest beginnings in 2015, Vika Hope Foundation has grown in strength from a whisper to a large body that straddles the NGO stratosphere in Abia and Nigeria.
I would say that Vika Hope Foundation is an avenue for my husband and myself to reach out to the people, touching lives and helping the less privileged. Every project of the foundation enjoys the support of my husband. And in fact, a lot of the ideas and initiatives come from him.
Vika Hope Foundation has carried out interventions in health, education, empowerment for women and young people, housing for the indigent, sexual and gender-based violence, youth orientation, rural infrastructure, sports, mobility for the disabled, environmental sustainability, water and sanitation, to mention just a few. One of the major ongoing programs of the foundation is the Sickle Cell Project. Under this program, Vika Hope Foundation runs a state-of-the-art sickle cell center in Umahia, which was commissioned in July 2017 by the wife of the president, Hajia Aisha Buhari. Another modern purpose-built center has been completed in Aba and will be commissioned by September 2020. It will be the permanent location for the Vika Hope Aba Sickle Cell Center, which has been operating temporarily in a set of buildings inside the Aba General Hospital. The Sickle Cell Project of Vika Hope Foundation provides the cheapest possible care for patients with sickle cell in the state. Free drugs and treatment are offered to patients. The Vika Hope Diagnostic Centers also parade the best possible equipment for diagnosis of ailment associated with the disease, as well as other ranges of diseases, including hypertension, diabetes, and of course, breast cancer, with the center boasting of a 2D sonograph mammography imaging machine, one of the best in the eastern parts of Nigeria. Vika Hope Foundation has been offering free breast examination to Abia women at its two centers in Aba and Umahia every weekday since September 2019. As part of its Sickle Cell Project, Vika Hope Foundation has mounted a huge sensitization campaign running throughout the state, visiting schools, churches, markets and homes to speak to families and young people about the disease and how to prevent it. Vika Hope Foundation has drawn the Abia State government into the SCD campaign. Sickle cell desk offices have been set up at the 17 local government areas to handle counseling, testing, advocacy sensitization, and liaison with rural patients, with plans in the pipeline to upgrade the offices to full-fledged centers. Vika Hope Foundation instigated the introduction of Abia State Law No. 5 of 2018 by the Abia State House of Assembly and assented to by the governor. The law makes it compulsory for all Abians to test for and have the blood group and genotype status published on their identity cards. The objectives will drive down the prevalence of sickle cell disease. In trying to contribute its quota towards making the world a healthier place, Vika Hope Foundation, through Vika Hope Pregi Care, has carried out interventions in maternal and child health care and nutrition, distributing maternity packs to thousands of expectant mothers, providing nutrition supplements to mothers and children, and creating pathways for mothers to access antenatal care, especially during COVID-19. The foundation supports the free school meal program of the Abia State government by the warming pupils in public schools routinely to ensure they are not only well fed but healthy. The foundation, collaborating with the Nestle Nutrition Institute of Africa and Nigeria Institute of Neonatal Medicine, has trained over 300 health personnel on neonatal resuscitation, a skill that saves the lives of babies who find it difficult to breathe at delivery. The foundation has worked with Jemison Health Services USA Incorporated and Abia State Government in training over 150 first responders, including Federal Road Safety, the Nigeria Police, State Fire Service workers, Civil Defense Officers, Wardens of Nigeria Correctional Services, in the American Heart Association Certified Basic Life-Saving Cardiopulmonary Resuscitation and First Aid. Another major plank in its health sector intervention is in picking up the hospital bills of indigent patients. Hundreds of the indigent sick, including newly delivered mothers who are stranded in the hospitals, mothers of multiple births, such as triplets and quadruplets, are rescued by the foundation on a daily basis. Another area Vikaho Foundation has recorded unprecedented and celebrated success is the intervention in providing housing for indigent widows and families under its Widows and Indigent Shelter Scheme. 88 housing units of 2 and 3 bedroom bungalows have been built all over the state, providing decent accommodation for an estimated 500 persons. In an effort to alleviate poverty and empower women, 1,328 rural women, traders and local businesses have received empowerment equipment and cash to start small businesses. These had an indirect impact on 8,000 people who are members of the benefiting families. In 13 communities, including Ameke Abreba, Ahaba Imenyi, Abala Obingwa, Umuchu Ihechowa, Oloko Ikwano, Obulumobo, Obaja Ugunagbo, Umwanwa Umuapara, and Ndielu Ugweke, Vikaho Foundation facilitated the construction of market stores to provide a conducive business environment for women to trade. 9 communities also benefited from borehole projects of the foundation. One poverty alleviation program instituted by the Vikaho Foundation is the Springboard Skills Acquisition Program that trains young people and women, imparting skills that can enable them start small businesses and be self-reliant. The program goal is to train over 1,065 persons in various skills across the 17 local government areas of Abia State. The National Directorate of Employment, NDE, is facilitator to the program. The beneficiaries undergo 3 months intensive training that includes business development skills. They receive equipment and small startup capital at the end of their training. Currently, 600 Abians have been trained in various skills under this program in 12 local council areas. Of this number, 450 have been presented with equipment and startup capital, with the remaining 150 to be empowered soon. The program was formally launched by Governor Okezie Pazo on the 22nd of March 2016 at the Central School, Umuabiakwa, Obingwa. Vicar Hope has provided succor to disabled persons too. A total of 328 wheelchairs and crutches were distributed to physically challenged persons, while 150 amputees received artificial limbs, courtesy of the foundation in collaboration with an Indian-based charity organization, Tolerance. Interventions carried out by the foundation in the areas of empowerment and welfare earned the foundation the special consultative status of United Nations Economic and Social Council, granting the foundation the opportunity to have a representative at the United Nations General Assembly or at other subsidiary meetings of the United Nations being held in New York, Geneva, or other parts of the world, and opening up new avenues for Vicar Hope Foundation to enjoy global collaboration. From its inception, Vicar Hope Foundation has had a clear-cut mission for young people and education from its numerous orientation programs, moral counseling programs, health and career development programs, digital skills training, and entrepreneurship development of young people. The foundation has kept its eyes on the ball, driven by the passion of Okezie and Nkechi Ikpeazu. The foundation has made capital investment in educational infrastructure. Three sets of classroom blocks were constructed in Obingwa local government area through Vicar Hope Foundation. Sets of classroom furniture were also donated to schools in Bende, Ikweno, and Obingwa local government areas. 400,000 exercise books and learning materials were also distributed to pupils with support and collaboration from well-meaning Abians. Successes recorded by the foundation in the field of education and young people is reminiscent of the background of the two protagonists. Governor Okezie Ikpeazu, son of a celebrated teacher, has had a long career in teaching and empowering young people, while his wife, Nkechi Ikpeazu, had spent several years in the classroom before joining public service. The two have committed themselves to a life of academic excellence with both bagging doctorate degrees in various fields. The proposed Ishmael Ikpeazu Memorial Library is a dream realized for the chief promoter of Vicar Hope Foundation, Governor Okezie Ikpeazu. The project, when realized, will benchmark the life of service and love which the Ikpeazu family has for Abia State, as demonstrated through the life-changing and enhancing projects that Vicar Hope Foundation has bequeathed to the Abia people.